The director of The Grudge and also the godmother of horror. Let's give a big warm welcome to Nicolas Pesce and Lin Shaye.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I love horror movies, but I hear this stuff.
Oh my god, Lin. I'm so starstruck. This is the first time ever. I met a lot of celebrities, but this is the first time that I felt this. We've been dating. I cried. Just thinking,
Lin's the best.
Yeah, I'm so flattered. I can't tell you. Well, for me, it's as flattering as it is for you. You also look great.
Thank you so much.
We're recording.
Hello, Lin. Hello again.
How do you do?
Hello. My name is Prince. I have a YouTube channel. It's called Prince the Guzman Transformations. I'm doing horror stuff, toys, everything, pranks. So first of all, to you, Nick, and to Sam Raimi, thank you so much for blessing us with another The Grudge movie. We're starting the year, right? As horror fans, we get a new The Grudge movie. It's R-rated, and there's Lin Shaye in it. What more can we ask for? So this has been the question to you all the time. What's new in the table? What's new in this The Grudge movie?
Well, this for the first time, it's rated R. So as a result, we got to be a lot more adult with the subject matter and tell adult stories, more mature stories. But it's also way gorier, way more intense, way scarier. And I think just to be able to like up that gore factor was a lot of fun.
Yeah. Your character, Elise Rainier, from Insidious, is really insanely famous in the Philippines, as well as The Grudge. So a lot of people in my country are anticipating this.
Oh my god, so that's a lot of pressure. Yeah.
Can you tell us about your character here, Faith Matheson?
Faith is an older woman. In the film, there are basically three different women of three different generations with three different issues and problems. And Faith has dementia. She is determined to kill herself before the dementia kills her. She keeps trying, but it doesn't work, and they even hire a suicide. So she and her husband of probably 50 years, they had a very wonderful relationship for that period of time. There's a scene that is not included in the film, which shows them reminiscing on the couch about their life when they were happy together and she was not sick. And so you get a feeling of who she was with him then. And they hire a suicide assistant, this woman who's played by Jackie Weaver, to help her die. But before that can happen, bad things start to happen to her. And from living in this space, as well as I think the weakness that her whole system is weakened by the dementia and by the fear of the dementia. And this is kind of an additional element to The Grudge, that it's not just living in the house. To me, it was also the weakness that these women were in because of their own lives. I mean, the problems they were having. So for Faith, I mean, she gets attacked by this ghost, basically, who then takes her all the way down. And we mean all the way down.
All the way
really.
Down.
Really?
All the way down. That's so depressing.
Yes, it was really. I know, really. Even I
really
still...
Sad
I
would, movie.
You know, when I talk sad about movie. It, I hold my hand.
Okay, so I just want to show you something. I mentioned earlier that I'm into horror transformations. So these are my works from your past movies. So I did a cute face. I think you like this on Instagram. I was
oh my god, babe! Yeah, totally.
Did she like my pose?
No, that's fantastic.
And this,
the cute face.
So was that you under
the
makeup?
Yeah, that's me and makeup.
Cool. Those are fantastic. I should show those to
Joe. I was an actor before, but I really put so much effort into my YouTube channel right now with this, because I really love
these
horror.
These are fantastic.
Awesome. And this is my last creation. I did my best. I hope you like it. This is her.
Wait, who's in your tonsil? It looks like...
That's my tonsil.
Oh my god!
I thought it was her.
So you've battled with a lot of demons, obviously, and that's what I love with your films. You know, these creatures, I really love creatures. What makes this entity, mythological evil, the Grudge, different among all those demons you've battled. You battled with a djinn, with an incubus. I've seen every film.
I think with this one, I lose.
Yeah, this one you lose. That's it.
You can't beat this one.
Really, yeah. This you have no recourse. There's no matter what you think you can do to beat it, you can't.
How's your experience creating this iconic horror franchise? How was it? How's your experience working on The Grudge, and how's your experience working with Lin Shaye?
Well, Lin is amazing. Lin is so much fun, and first of all, I gotta say, she's got energy for like days. And there's this scene where she, you've seen the movie?
Yes.
Yeah. So when she jumps off the spoiler alert, when she does the stair jump, there was a moment where I always say, Lin, if I had said to her, hey, so we're actually gonna have you jump and you're gonna die at the end of this take, she would have been like, okay, cool, okay, tell me where to go. Where do you want me to splat? And she's just so game, oh, it's crazy.
Inspiring.
Yeah. That even inspires me.
Okay, so this is just a fun question. My viewers will love this. You've worked with horror movies a lot. Your first movie was amazing. Of course, The Godmother of Horror. Do you really believe that things like this really exist? Paranormal?
You know, I don't know if there's entities like this walking around, but I am superstitious, and I do believe that there's something more. And I think that, you know, enough people have had some sort of experience that something must be going on, and I definitely believe in, like, you walk into a place and you can feel the energy and that there's bad juju around, and
I feel the same way. There's so much we know nothing about. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's so many things that we can't explain that I think it would be totally egocentric and narcissistic to think that we're it, you know. It's like we think we're the only ones in the universe. Maybe not so much. I mean, there's too many. So yes, I absolutely, and I think you have to be respectful of that. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I feel like I don't carry a lot of fear around with me because I am respectful of, hello, how are you? Enjoy yourself. I'm good. You be good. But I mean, to acknowledge without, the more you close off, I think the more in jeopardy you are in general in life. I think you need to, that thing about letting energy come and go is a really important thing to learn how to do. Not always successful, but I really aim for that.
That's awesome. Thank you so much. We can't wait to see this movie.
Oh my goodness.
You know, I love horror movies, but I hear this stuff.
What the hell? Oh my god, you broke your camera.
My god! Okay, we're so excited. I'm so excited for my country to see this. Thank you so much.
They're gonna see that too. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Can I hug you again?
Spencer, something happened to me at 44 Rayburn Drive.
Someone was murdered at that house.
Why did you never go into that place?
Something never felt right about it.
Looks like we got another one.
Do you think that the body we found is related? Hello? I went to the house.
Hello? Police department.
I think something followed me home.
Mommy, what's going on? What's wrong?
We need to leave right now.